Hi, I'm J.D. Hilberry, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about drawing paper. The kind of paper that you choose to draw on will have more effect on the final outcome of your drawing than any other technique that you can think of. Sometimes people use the wrong paper and can't figure out why the techniques aren't working for them. So I'm going to show you a little bit about my favorite papers, how to handle paper, and I think this will be very informative for most of you out there. Before I get started on explaining what papers I like to use and why, I want to show you why it's very important to keep your hands off of your paper in any place where you think you're going to be doing your drawing. Always pick up your paper by the edges to move it around or to hold it. I usually tape down my paper so I'm not tempted to hold it with my hand, which is one of the things that a lot of people do. They'll use their other hand to hold down the paper, and they end up putting their fingers in places where later they want to do some shading and it ends up being a bit of a mess. So let me just show you what can happen here with my hands on the paper here. I'm holding down my paper so it doesn't move around in this area, and later on I'm going to want to be doing some shading there. So let me just show you what happens when I try to shade over right where my hand was here. This is just a 6B graphite pencil that I'm using here. I'm just going to go over where my finger was resting. Now, they used to use graphite for fingerprint dusting powder. That's how much it's attracted to the oils in your hands. I don't have any lotion or anything like that on my hands either. And even if you think your hands are fairly dry, there is still oil on your hands that can end up making it very difficult to do smooth textures. You can kind of see how there's a darker area right in the middle where my hand was resting. And that's bad enough like this, but let's just say that I wanted to create a smoother texture than this. Let's say I was going to do a smooth skin texture, or I was drawing glass or the wrinkles in paper or some of those other kinds of things that where you want a very, very smooth texture. So I'm going to take a chamois here, and my goal is to try to smooth this out as much as possible. And watch what happens. That fingerprint really gets pronounced now. So you can see how that's probably going to be difficult to make that darker area match the rest of my tone that I put in there. You know, this has happened to me before. You know, I've forgotten and put my hand down on the paper. It's very, very hard to try to make this darker area match that area. You know, you can try to go in with a kneaded eraser or something to try to make it not so pronounced. But again, I try to make very, very smooth transitions for a lot of my work. And once you have those fingerprints on your paper, there's no fix for this problem, because the paper is just going to act totally different there. You know, I can try to back it all the way out with an eraser, and then try to go over it to see if that helps. But you'll see, it'll just come right back. So that's a problem that hopefully I can help you guys avoid. Even if your hand isn't in a place where you're going to be drawing, let's say it's way over there on the side, you're trying to hold your paper way over on the edge. When you're drawing and you have lots of graphite dust being kind of thrown around here, you know, through blending or the pencil or whatever. I mean, there's a lot of stuff that kind of gets floating around in the air. It's also going to end up coming over here and landing in wherever your fingerprint has been. So when you end up with smudges all over your paper and you can't figure out why, that's really one of the main reasons. That's why you need to always pick up your paper by the edges where you're not going to be drawing on it. Now, the other thing I recommend is putting some sort of a barrier where your hand is going to be drawing. Remember, I just had my hand resting right on the paper here. That is also a mistake because of the oils on the palm of your hand. So what I do is create a barrier of some sort with another sheet of paper. I'm just going to get a piece of paper like this. This is just regular notebook paper. And you can get a piece of duct tape. And I'm just going to make it so it's sticky on both sides, just rolling up the duct tape a little bit here. I'm going to put that on the paper, stick that right on my hand, So now no matter where I go while I'm drawing, there's a barrier between my hand and my drawing. So you'll see when I start showing more detailed drawings here in my videos, you'll always see this piece of paper on my hand here. Another thing I'll do is cover some areas with another piece of paper just to make sure that this doesn't slide around too much. Because you may remember in my video about blending, a piece of paper can actually be used for blending material too. So just because you have this on here, don't think that that's going to not smear things around. It's going to keep the oils from your hand from transferring onto the paper, but it still can smear the graphite. So you need another barrier, another piece of paper to keep everything from sliding around. Now, it doesn't have to be notebook paper. I know some people use just wax paper. You can do the same thing with wax paper. Tape that onto your hand and it can be a little bit slicker. People also use things called a mall stick, which is a thing that painters use a lot. And it's basically a piece of wood that raises your hand up off of the paper or the canvas, whatever you're drawing on, so it keeps you from touching it with your drawing hand. Personally, I've never liked my hand to be raised up off the paper that far. It's a little bit uncomfortable for me to draw like that. So I have found this method to be very useful in getting very, very smooth textures. Now, I know that some people even blend with their fingers and they've been able to make that work with the style of artwork that they do. For me, personally, that has never worked when I'm trying to create very, very smooth textures and trying to make sure that everything is very, very predictable on my drawing. I don't like to not know what's going to happen. And blending with your fingers, you are always adding a little bit of oil on that area, and that can be very unpredictable. You never know whether that, how much oil you're putting on there compared to another place. If you happen to be a little more sweaty during one drawing session than the other, it's not going to act the same. So hopefully that's a good hint that to help keep your drawings clean. The next thing I want to do is show you some different types of paper. So there's a front side and a back side to paper. And what I want to do is show you the difference and give you some reasons why I like one side of the paper over the other. This is Arches 140-pound hot press watercolor paper, which is one of my favorite papers, and it comes in a 22 by 30 sheet. And what I want to do is show you the front side of this paper has a watermark on it that you can see. If you shine a light behind the paper, you can see this watermark there. It says Arches France right there. That would be the front side of this paper. Now, the side I like to use is the reverse side of this paper, and I'll show you that. So you see that that watermark is written in reverse, and that's the side that I like to use. And I've already started here adding a little bit of tone to the paper here. This is the side that I like, and you can see the texture that that makes. Now let me fold this over so you can see the other side of this paper. I'll zoom in a little so hopefully you can see the differences here. You'll notice that the front side of the paper has a little bit more of a textured pattern to it. It's more like little X's, or sometimes you'll see more of a diagonal pattern compared to the other side, which it's more of a random pattern to it. You can't really see what direction that I put the strokes in. There's tiny little dots and dashes all over in this paper that you can kind of pick out certain directions that it tends to be going in. There are many different types of paper, and this is more of a cold press paper here. And you'll see what I'm talking about with how much texture that this paper has. I would not want to use this paper and try to create a really nice smooth skin tone. Even if I try to blend it with a chamois, which normally can get the very smoothest textures, it doesn't end up looking very smooth. I avoid really rough papers like cold press papers and some drawing papers if I want to create textures on my own without having the paper overpower my textures. Now you don't want to go too far the other direction either. You need a little bit of tooth on the paper to make the medium, graphite or charcoal, stick to it. What I have here is a paper with very little tooth on it on the left and a B graphite pencil. You can get very, very smooth textures on this smooth paper, but you can't get as dark of values. Same pencil over here on my Arches paper can get much darker than you can over here on this very, very smooth paper. So don't forget, tooth is not a bad thing. You need a little bit of tooth on the paper to hold the charcoal or graphite to get very nice dark values. A good paper to practice on is this Strathmore 400 series drawing paper. Now it's acid free, which is one good thing going for it, but it is not archival. It means that it has wood pulp in it, which eventually could end up turning yellow and getting a little brittle. So if you're going to do your masterpiece that people are going to want to look at hundreds of years from now, do it on a paper that is 100% rag paper. And that's what that Arches paper was that I showed you a few minutes ago. But this is an excellent paper for practice. It has a lot of the same characteristics as the Arches does. It's just much less expensive. It also has a good side and a bad side though too, and you can do the same sort of experiments on this to find the side that you like the best for whatever drawing that you're going to do. So I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial on paper. Please make sure you sign up for my email list for future videos, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks. Bye.